So when I start preparing the sub, I go checking all the thrusters, they're not damaged. All the air system, air tanks, lights, equipment that's outside the sub, it's not damaged, it's ready to go in the water. So when I'm done with this, I'm getting inside, checking my air system with air and checking the tanks that they're blowing, the vents, they can vent the tanks when to leave the surface. Electrical system, also all the sonars, cameras, equipment, it depends really what you need for the goal.
I'm diving since I'm 8. I've made over 3,000 dives with scuba dives.
So we'll wait for the second sub to be in and we dive together.
Half of my life I'm underwater. And all the ships are recognizable, of course. So I know where I am, I know what I'm doing, but every time, especially when I'm filming, I have to be control 200% of the sub. I have to be life support to see that everything is good, the sub is working, camera's running. One person job is pretty hard, but that's what we do. I'm happy that I have this job. And it's a unique thing that I'm doing, actually. Not many people did this. As you see, you experience like for first time. For me, it's like every dive, this feeling gets to me. It's amazing, it's interesting, it's cool, it's dangerous. It looks easy, but we're 100 meters, 300 feet below sea surface. And we need to understand that not all the wrecks are that shallow. Let's say for sub diving, it's pretty shallow. We do diving up to 1 kilometer, where it gets more tougher and tougher. I mean, the sub is very responsive. You can control it with one hand, as you've seen before. It's one joystick, but my other hand is free. I'm sitting comfortable here. So it's pretty easy to move. It gets hard when the conditions are getting worse. Visibility, currents, nets, obstacles, and then, especially when you're film, you have to be in control. You have to move the sub very slowly, very gentle, to make a very nice shot. I'm getting exhausted after every dive, let's say, especially mentally. And blue collar is getting into your eyes, you're getting tired pretty fast. So I can do 6-7 hours, that's the maximum, I'd say. Sub has many different features, especially safety features. From life support, we can stay in emergency situations 92 hours. We can wait for the rescue operation or deployment of ROV. Second sub, we can assess then the situation, what's happening. If we're stuck, let's say our manipulator arm is stuck, we can release it. We can drop our battery pods if they're flooded. We're breathing 1 atmosphere air. So we can go up straight away, open the hatch, and nothing will happen to our bodies. We can go up, down, as many as submarine will allow us. At the back of the submarine, I have oxygen tanks. Inside, I have a scrubber, CO2, so it gets rid of the CO2 levels. With add of oxygen, gets the air back to its normal level, so we can breathe fresh air, basically. We're now visiting our favorite wreck, Britannic, the sister ship of Titanic. It lays on the bottom on depth of 116 meters. On the right side, its bow is broken. We need to know for sure if it's a mine or a torpedo. It's still a big question after 100 years. They say it's Everest for divers, but for me, I can go up to 1,000 meters. It's a monster again, it's a beauty monster. It's one thing and another laying on the seabed. It's insane, first of all. Because I know the history of the ship pretty well. The bridge is the most exciting place to see, because you can imagine in your head how captain was standing there, what's happening was that time. And during this year we're filming a movie and we're filming on the bridge. It was a mixture of feelings, because you're standing in a real bridge that's there, it's everything in place, people, captain again, and in my memory I can build it into underwater wreck and how it, and Yeah, it's amazing. I have no other really words to say about Britannic. I've been down to many wrecks, but not everyone gets this something. So something in this wreck that keeps bringing me back.